Yes, class 10. Today we are going to start with the chapter Making of a Scientist. So the name of the chapter indicates that the chapter is about the making of a scientist, how a scientist is produced. So what do you think? How a scientist is made? How a scientist is made? What do you think? By doing experiments, only experiments, by working hard work. Hard work for how much long? For how long? Whole life, as much as they want. Okay, whole life, yes. Okay, since childhood. So here is the story of a famous scientist, E. Bright, who has found the reason of replication of cells. How the cells replicate and how DNA is replicated means it is copied to the next cells, right? And for that, what he has told that he has, as he was inclined towards scientific experiments since his childhood. As since his childhood, he was carrying forward these kind of experiments. And it was not only he who was interested in science, rather his mother, she was also very much helpful towards him. So he was conducting basic experiments. Many a times he has failed also. And moreover, since childhood, you know that he has collected almost all the species of the butterflies. He has continued his experiment. It was since his childhood that he has carried forward his experiments and it has led to further. Okay. How it happened. So this we are going to study in this chapter about E. Bright. So the writer, he wants to give us the message that that success is not an overnight story. It needs your perspiration. It needs your perseverance. It needs your hard work. It needs consistency in work also. That ultimately result in the positive effects. Okay, so as I told that E. Bright, since childhood he was doing the experiments. When he was in very lower grades, he was doing the experiments, mounting the slides. Okay, you people will come to know about mounting of slides in 6 or 7, and there only the teacher is showing you. He is doing it since his childhood. He is mounting the slides. He is collecting the you can say pupils of the butterflies. Then he has also come to know how to raise them. He has collected some different species of butterflies and raised them in his, you can say, garage. And there from then he was, you can say, marking the butterflies, putting marks so that whenever they will migrate and come back, he will be able to recognize. And when he was conducting, or he was forward, you can say, pursuing his education in college and university, he was again following it. It was only the efforts that one has to put in so that they can give positive results. So in case of E. Bright, it was his efforts since his childhood. It was his hard work that he has put on daily, over and overnight again. He's working along with his one of his friend, and he was able to get the result. And finally, he got the acclaim. He got, you can say, recognition for discovering this new method, that how cells they replicate, how they copy DNA. And this, so he became worldwide famous scientist. So the chapter, it has been started with the explanation that first of all, there you can say their research paper, it was published in a journal, which was never, you can say, publishing the papers of students. But it is for the first time. Why? Because they have made an exemplary research and made and came out with an exemplary, you can say, research work that ultimately it has solved many queries of science. Okay, so let us read what is and how it is done in the chapter by E. Bright. So the making of a scientist. Robert E. Bright has received the Self Scholar Award and the Schering-Plough Award for Biochemistry and Molecular Biology. It was his fascination for butterflies that opened the world of science to him. So how it happened? It was only his fascination for butterflies. I told that since his childhood, he was collecting butterflies. It was only the collection of the butterflies, how they were being collected and how they were being, you can say, raised. He was doing since his childhood that led to his discovery. So if you know where you are going and you are putting in all your efforts in that direction, that will definitely come out with positive results. And this has happened with Ebright. Okay. So let us read. At the age of 22, a former scout of the year, it means that he was not only an academician, he was participating in other activities of the school also. And this he has mentioned, the narrator, I will also make a mention of it, that how he was doing, he was a good debater also. He's participating in debates and ultimately he's getting prizes. Okay. So at the age of 22, when he was a former scout of the year, he has got this, you can say, title also, excited the scientific world with the new theory on how cells work. So at the age of mere 22, he has made this discovery, and he has made this discovery, new theory that how cells, they work. Richard H. Ebright and his college roommate explained the theory in an article in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Science. So first of all, who has presented it? It was Ebright and his roommate who were doing all this experimentation, who were carrying forward all these experiments and studies since very long time. And they have explained their theory, what they have observed, what they have came out with in an article, name of the article underlined, please, the Proceedings of the National Academy of Science. So let me tell you that this chapter, it is not a story. Okay. Of course, a story is there of Ebright and his life. But ultimately, in this chapter, many factual descriptions are given. So you should be very careful. Okay. And in this chapter, you have very less chance to invent on your own. If you know the facts, only then you will be able to attempt the answers, right? So many a time students are facing most difficulty here in this chapter. So first of all, where his proceedings or where his theory was published? Speak out, where his theory was published? It was in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Science. So where his theory was published, first of all? Proceedings of the National Academy of Science, right? What was the age of Ebright? Was he alone to make this discovery? No, he was not at all alone to make this discovery, but he was along with his roommate. He has made this discovery, right? So, it was the first time this important scientific journal had ever published the work of college students. So what was new in this, you can say, journal? That it is for the first time that this journal has published the work of college students. Otherwise, I told you that they are not publishing the work of the college students. Right? In sports, that would be like making the big leagues. League, you know what is league? What is league? Group pursuing anything, one thing. Okay, for example, league of sports in matches. Okay, taking place in one, you can say, particular sport. Okay, so it was the first time this important scientific journal had ever published the work of college students in sports. That would be like making the big leagues at the age of 15 and hitting a home run. Home run, your first time at bat. So they have compared it with sports, like how in sports the matches are being held, and just at the age of 15, when you reach at 15, you come to the main sport and ultimately hit the target. Richard E. Bright, it was the first in a long string of achievements in science and other fields. And it all started with butterflies. And for E. Bright, when it all started, it was all started with butterflies. When in his all his achievements, he has made his discoveries possible, gave him the concrete form, and ultimately all this started with his interest in butterflies since his childhood. So, an only child. So here is the main thing about E. Bright, that he was the only child of the parents, no brother and sister. E. Bright grew up north of Reading. So where he was brought up? He was brought up in north of Reading place in Pennsylvania. There wasn't much I could do there, he said. I certainly couldn't play football or baseball with a team of one. But there was one thing I could do, that is collect things. So he has mentioned, as I was all alone in the family, so he said, I was not able to play any game which is played in a team, for example, football or baseball. Why? Because he could not play it as he is all alone in the family. So what he said, but there was one thing that I can do is to collect the things. Okay, so this he was doing. So he did, and did he ever? So this is the only thing, that is collection of things he was doing, and he was doing it ever and ever again in order to pass his time and to pursue his interests. Beginning in kindergarten, E. Bright collected butterflies with the same determination that has marked all his activities. So see, when he is in kindergarten, you know what is the age of a child? 5 to 6 years, not more than that. He has collected different kind of butterflies. He has marked those butterflies also. He has marked those butterflies, and that was the first activity that he has done. He also collected rocks, fossils, coins. Fossils means dead remains in the form of stones. He has collected rocks, and he was also collecting coins. He became an eager astronomer too, sometimes stargazing all night. And he is also inquisitive. He also wanted to know about stars. And sometimes at night, he would sit for longer hours outside in the open so that to look at the stars. So he also liked to be an astronomer. So what are the different things done by E. Bright? Yes. What are the different things done by E. Bright? You can say, first interest was to collect the butterflies. But then he was also interested in collecting rocks, fossils, and coins. Okay. And he also wanted to be an E. Bright. From the first, he had a driving curiosity along with a bright mind. Driving means something pushing, curiosity, along with the bright mind. So since he was a young boy, he had a long, or you can say deep heartened curiosity along with bright mind. It was not only his curiosity that has led him to achieve success or to become the winner of these prizes, but it was also, of course, his bright mind that has helped him. He also had a mother who encouraged his interest in learning. Sometimes the question is there, what is the role of mother, okay, in E. Bright's life? So you will very well read, just in one paragraph it is mentioned. His mother played a very active role in the upbringing of E. Bright as a scientist, as she was involving him in scientific activities since his childhood. So he said that my mother always encouraged his interest in learning. She took him on trips, bought him telescopes, microscopes, cameras, mounting materials, and other equipment, and helped him in many other ways. So what his mother has done, that his mother often took him to different kind of trips. Okay, then she has also bought him different kind of telescopes, microscopes, cameras, mounting materials means to make slide. Okay, slide covers, mounting materials, you know now. Father was not there. that will be mentioned in the forthcoming paragraph. And other equipment and helped him in many other ways. So I told you that it was his mother who was the driving force behind his interest. Her mother used to bring all the things related to science for him so that he can carry forward his experiments. I was the only companion until he started school, his mother said. So his mother has mentioned that as there was nobody else in the family, so his mother was the only companion to help him and to bring him up, right? To carry forward his interest. And after that, I would bring home friends for him. But at night, we just did things together. Richie was my whole life after his father died when Richie was in third grade. So Richie is the nickname of Robert E. Bright. So his mother used to say that it was his entire life. He was his complete life. He was his entire, you can say, the only person in her life. And she said, during the daytime, I used to bring his friends to our house so that he can pass some time. But afterwards, at night only, what we have? We did things together. It means that her mother was not letting him so that he can do on his own. No. But she is also helping him, taking complete interest in his activities so that he can continue his things of interest. And she said that he was his entire life, whole life, because his father was dead when he was just in grade 3. She and her son spent almost every evening at the dining room table. If he did not have things to do, I found work for him. Not physical work, but learning things. So her mother said, every evening we used to spend in our dining room on the table doing things together. Okay, she said that if he doesn't have any work, I always bring work for him. But that doesn't mean that kind of work, physical work. Go and bring this thing, make a pile of this, arrange these books. No. She said it was the things that he likes to do. It means learning new things. I tried to give him a push to learn new things so that he can learn new type of things. And he liked it and he wanted to learn. She said that of course he liked all these things and she also has given him enough opportunity to learn. So this is the role her mother had played. So what is the role of the mother who will explain? Played in bringing of E. Bright? Yes, what is the role of mother played? Okay, right. She was the only, he was the only companion. He was the only companion of her mother. This is what you want to say, right? Okay. And her mother is bringing different kind of materials like microscopes, cameras, mounting materials. Okay. So that he can carry forward his interest. And her mother used to spend a lot of time in the evening along with his child so that she can carry out the experiments as well as the learning work along with him. Learning doesn't mean rote learning here. What does learning means? Learning new things. Right. Learning means learning new things. And ultimately, what is there? So, what happened? So, she was complete companion of her son. Okay. Now, and learn he did. He earned top grades in school and every day things. We was just like every other kid, his mother said. So his mother said, what he did is only learning. And in the school, he is always getting top grades. And she has also mentioned like on everyday things means if we say that we are doing abnormal things or not other than normal, that was not right. She's saying we were like the other normal kids as they were in their homes and we were playing together and we were doing the things. So nothing special about him. By the time he was in the second grade, E. Bright had collected all 25 species of butterflies found around his hometown. So see, when he was just in second grade, how many type of different species of butterflies he has collected? 25. And all the species were available around their house. And you can see the following table. Yes, read this table. You can see here. White M, hair streak, wood nymphs and stats, brush-footed butterflies. I mean, these are the different categories. Okay, species and then subspecies of butterflies. Okay, these are the name. And here it is mentioned in the third row, Vishray. And on that, these butterflies, he has continued his experiments. Okay. That probably would have been the end of my butterfly collecting, he said. But then my mother got me a children's book called The Travels of Manat X, Name of the Butterfly. That book, which told how Manat butterflies migrate to Central America, opened the world of science to the eager young collector. So he, what statement he has given, he said that maybe when he has collected all the different type of butterflies, that would be the end of his collection and that would be the end of his interest. But his interest was given an ignition. It was given a spark by his mother. How? When she has brought a book which is named as The Travels of Manat X. This book has opened a new way of learning for him. And he said there were a number of things given which were fascinating me, who was only a butterfly collector. Yes, you stand up. Name, please. Huh? Sajal. Okay, tell me that what was the role of the mother played in E. Bright's life to bring him to the rise or the name of a scientist? Yes, you will be able. Next, sit down. Yes, like what things he wanted? Chocolates, toffees. Okay, about science, like for example, telescopes, cameras, microscopes, mounting material. Apart from this, what role is being played? Sit down, please. Apart from this bringing material, what role else is played by E. Bright's mother? Very bad. Simarpreet, you will be able to answer. How learning things? What kind of learning she has brought to him? Sit down next. What kind of learning her mother has brought to him? Sit down. Yes, Kiti. What role is played by his mother in bringing up of a scientist? Right. Very good. Her mother has given her the book, that is Travels of Manat X. Otherwise, he would have stopped there after collecting the butterflies. Moreover, her mother was also a complete companion in doing the things. In the evening, they used to spend their time together in the dining room doing things together. Okay. And every time when he is not having any kind of work, her mother used to bring work for him. What kind of work? It was not a physical work, but some learning work. And what was the achievement of Fulbright as a young child when he was in grade 2? Yes, he has collected all the 25 different type of species that were available in their hometown. Okay, so it means that Fulbright, sit down please. Fulbright was interested in collection of butterflies since his childhood. So this is really very amazing on his part. You can see here in the table name of the butterflies. White M hair streak, Acadian hair streak, bronze copper, bog copper, purplish copper, eastern tail blue, Melissa blue, silvery blue, then snout butterflies, wood nymphs, eye brown, wood nymph, grayling one, in monarchs, monarch or it is milkweed, whites and sulfurous ones, it's Olympia, cloudless circle, European cabbage, and then variegated, it is Fillery, Harris checkpaws, Pete Crescent, Morning Clock, Painted Lady, Buckeye, Viceroy, White Admiral, Red Spotted, Purple, Blackberry. I don't think so we have ever heard these names. We have never heard, even I have not never heard these names. So see how, means he was advanced in his knowledge since his childhood. This is the greatness of great people, that they move ahead of time. What other people are doing, they are doing something extra. It is not the things that are done in common way that bring prizes, but it is the common things but done in an extraordinary way. Okay? So this is all about Fulbright that we have to learn today. So next afterwards, we will see that when he has started reading this book, Travels of Monarch X, then what change it has brought in his life. He has told that it has changed. Brought a change in his life, and in the next one we will see a change that what has been brought in his life. Okay, so that's all for today.